อันดับหนึ่งคนนี้เขาทำติดตาใช่ไหมใช่ไหมมันแชร์อะไรแคนคอมมูนิตี้ walk behind the river we do a lot of activities we do RCH like reproductive and child health activities we have the family planning unit we do ANC and paper clinic that is the focus one.We do deliveries, emergency, because I'm not a midwife, I do only the emergency deliveries. We do CWT services, we conduct home visits, and we do outreach clinics. We go outside our church compound to take care of those behind the river and communities that are far from us. We have eight stars in all.Three of us are living in the compound, and the others are living in town. We serve, during a normal clinic hours, the average people that we normally serve is around 15. But during CWC services, we can serve about 80 to 100 mothers. We start the clinic around 8, by the time we close, it will be about 5. It's normally a hectic clinic.ANC mothers, because it is focused, we don't have a normal day that they come. Anytime that you feel like coming to the clinic or it's your day to June, you can come for the clinic. And a day we can serve about 5 to 6 pregnant women. We do deliveries here, although we don't have a midwife, we are doing our best to conduct deliveries. The TBA too, sometimes when she gets.Cases because of the cordiality she normally comes with them here to conduct the delivery so that I think it will be like a supervised we are doing our way. We have challenges. Some of our challenges is we don't have security personnel here. In the night, somebody will come and wake you up and you don't know whom you are going to meet.So sometimes working in the night, we work in the night in fear because they come and wake you up, you don't know what you are coming to meet, whether the person is really coming to the clinic or the person is coming to harm you. We don't have a urinal or latrine for the outpatient. You detain a diarrhea patient here and when the person wants to go and medicate, it will be a problem. Sometimes you don't have to go and beg with those houses, house owners around us.For the person to go and do it for herself. It's a challenge. And accommodation for the staff. We are only 2 people living here. And in fact, the wife normally comes during the weekend. And if one person has gone on a weekend and the others who are staying in town, the night, you can't afford them to come and work. So you'll be the only person.Working in the night. Sometimes we work 2 hours from Friday to Monday without sleeping and in the morning we have to come to work. So it's very tedious. We are calling on non-government organizations, the government as a whole, to come and help us because we are all doing our best in helping to meet our Millennium Challenge goal. So we are calling on them to come and help us. Any help will be very much appreciated. Thank you very much.